Hi guys, this is Hector Castillo, Poppy from GirlsChase.com. And today I want to talk about how I can give you a rock hard erection. What can I do to make your life better? Do I need to get on my knees? Do I need to, you know, wear a cute outfit? Some people who like don't know who I am and this is like their first video of me, they're gonna be like, what? Is this guy crazy? Yes I am. Okay. Today, we're gonna talk about some tips that you can apply on your own without any help from me. I mean, if watching my videos does get you hard or wet, if you're a woman, let me know, send me a DM, and we can talk. But if you are not having as hard of erections that you want, and hard erections, rock hard erections, they're going to help with your sex. They're gonna help with sex, yes. You need an erection to have sex. No. When you're having sex with a kind of a, all of you guys know this, and girls as well, you know this. Pula mea.
Sorry, it's your fault.
Oh, what happened?
You moved, you leaned.
Okay, oh, okay.
Now, when you have sex.
Okay, cool. Wait, which part?
You can do it. Now, when you have sex.
Okay, cool. Now, when you have sex with a medium, soft dick, you're hard enough to get in, and you're hard enough to get deep, and you're hard enough to give her pleasure, but there's this thing that's lacking. And again, just like you girls and guys know what it's like to have a soft, medium, hard dick, you know what it's like to get fucked or to use a super fucking rock hard cock, diamond cock. It is one of the best things you can do with a woman, because even if your technique's not great, what you're doing is you're giving her the experience. You gotta remember, the sex happens up here even more than it happens down there. Yes, it's happening there physically, and there's a lot of things you can do physically, like rhythm or have a big dick or be really hard. But being really hard and also having a big dick or having good technique, what that does is it gets her here. And so, especially if you do have a small dick, and we actually have a video on what to do if you have a small dick, and I'll put it right here in the description below. If you can get hard, then you can compensate for a lot of that. And then if you do have a big dick, well, you want to use it to maximum potential, and you want to get super hard, because when you're really, really turned on and she's going to feel that, she's going to feel that passion, that lust and that desire that you have for her, it's going to be obvious. Wow, you're so hard. And I've had girls tell me like, this sex is great. And then we have this sex and there's just something going on where I'm just so turned on by her and I'm just so fucking hard, and she'll just be whimpering. She's like, you're so hard, it's so hot, oh my God. And she just loves that you are, because it doesn't lie, the dick doesn't lie, right? Just like the proof is in the pussy, the proof is in the dick. I'll leave it there, I'll come up with some like catchphrase for me that has to do with dicks. But just like the proof is in the pussy, and you know that a girl is liking something when she's wet and she's ready for it, then it's, she could say 10 different things, but that is the truth. Just the same with your cock. If your dick is hard, that's all that needs to be said. And your body is speaking for you and it's speaking the truth. And the truth is that you want her and you desire her. So that was a long explanation of why you should have a strong hard erection. But I like to preface my arguments and build my premises because I'm a nerd. So you want a hard dick. How do you get it? This is the tips. So first, take care of the basics. You should probably not smoke too much. You should probably not drink too much. You should probably work out. You should probably do cardiovascular workouts as well as lifting weights, so you have testosterone, and then the cardio takes care of your blood flow, because I don't know if you know, but it's blood that's going to your dick. And so you want to increase your heart strength so that it can pump a lot of blood there. But obviously the physical stuff doesn't take care of everything. You can eat well, you can work out, but you still don't have rock hard erections. And so that's when we have to do the mental stuff. So how do you change your mental behaviors and your mental models when it comes to sex? Stop watching porn, stop jerking off. Most problems with ED are solvable with those, and just go a few months without porn and a few months without jerking off, you will get hard just walking around, right? If you're a healthy male and also you're good mentally, you know this by you walking around and you'll see girls on the street and you get hard. If you're getting hard based on just looking at her, imagine how hard you're gonna get when you feel her wet pussy on your raw cock, or you feel her lips wrapping around your dick. That is going to just get you immeasurably hard, and you're gonna have a diamond dick. And so stop watching porn, stop jerking off. You want to also change the way you see women. One of the ways you can get over approach anxiety too, it helps, is when you see a woman on the street, Let's say you're having doubts or hesitations. Just imagine her naked, bent over, begging for you to fuck her. Okay, now you're excited. Now you're charged. Now you have this sexual energy. Fuck, you could go approach her while you have like half a boner. It's gonna give you this sexual energy. And the same applies to the whole seduction. You wanna have this sexual energy buffering and the foundation of your seduction and the words that are coming out. Everything that you're doing is sexualized. There's a sexual energy to your movements and your words and your eye contacts. So when you hypersexualize a woman, or if you wanna take it far enough, objectify her in that moment, you know, because when you're using a woman in bed, she's consenting to being your object of pleasure. And you want to just use her to your heart's content. And this is what women really love. They love when a man just uses her for his own pleasure. This is talked about a lot in The Alabaster Girl. It's a great book by Zamperion, and I'll put that in the description below. But the hottest sex is not technically great sex. It's sex when you're so passionate about her and your dick is so hard and you're just using her how you want. It could last 45 seconds and it could be some of the best sex in the world, or it could last an hour and it'd be mind fucking blowing sex. But if you have that lust behind you and you get that by visualizing her sexually, then you're gonna have a really, really hard dick. Another tip that kind of encompasses all of the ones that I just talked about is become hedonistic in general. Obviously, there are some potential downfalls to this lifestyle. A hedonist, for those of you who don't know, is someone who's very obsessed with pleasure. Where is the next place that they can get pleasure? Sex, alcohol, drugs, entertainment, adventures, thrills, you know, skydiving. Someone is in a hedonistic lifestyle. They are constantly entrapped in the search for pleasure. But these people do end up having a good time. So you do want to take some hedonistic traits and add them to your life if you do want to have a very fulfilling sex life, because sex is very, very primally satisfying, and it's something that is so ingrained in our body that it's almost necessary. You know, even the most austere religions still recognize that you're gonna have to have sex because it's such a primal part of your life, and so you might as well fucking enjoy it. So live a more hedonistic lifestyle. Get into your mind. Learn what fantasies you have in your mind. Look what you want to experience in life. What kind of girl you want to experience? How do you want to fuck her? What fantasies do you have about shit? Even other men. Like, just become hedonistic. Obviously, follow the moral compass that you believe that you should follow, and don't, you know, disrespect yourself, and don't do anything that would harm someone else or injure someone else. But you should explore your sexuality, and you should explore the pleasures that you want to follow as far as you are willing to follow them. But if you do open yourself up to a little bit of hedonism, you're gonna enjoy sex more, and you're gonna have a more rock hard cock because you're not sexually repressed and you don't have, and you've dealt with your sexual trauma, whatever it is, because of a Puritan background. Maybe you had some abuse when you were younger. You gotta deal with that, and you gotta go into here, and you can do it mentally or independently through meditation, or you can go see a psychiatrist, and you definitely need to work on your mind and deal with it because we want you to be healthy, but also open to the pleasures of life. Next thing is kind of funny, and sometimes I kind of joke that I'm becoming a good girl because I get a little bit more and more picky about who I wanna fuck and how I wanna fuck them. But I think it's a good progression. And one of the things that I'm starting to enjoy more is foreplay. Obviously, when I was younger, I just enjoyed boop, 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 put it in. Cool, I got laid. This is great. This is wet pussy. Awesome. But my tastes have become more refined. If I've had enough just random sex with random girls, and I'm gonna continue to have random sex with random girls, but I'm gonna have higher quality random sex with random women because I want to make it an experience. I want it to be, even if the experience lasts, you know, 5 minutes and we're ready to go and fuck, that 5 minutes can still be immeasurably pleasurable because there was a seduction there and there was fun there. But if you're not properly enjoying foreplay, it's gonna be bad for you and bad for her as well, because women need foreplay. This is why women read porn rather than watch it most of the time, because they want the experience, because that's what's gonna turn them on, is the full complete experience of a hot dominant guy who conquers her but also cares about her and is gonna take care of her in bed. And if you allow this experience to unfold by maybe moving a little bit slower, but not so slow that you're sacrificing the actual culmination of the seduction, the sex, for the experience. So don't do that. I have some guys like, oh, I just wanted to wait. I wanted to join more. And then they ended up not pulling and having sex. It's like, okay, you still got to remember the goal. The goal is still to have sex with her. But, you know, Let's say there's a, you know, you're ready to pull her, but you guys are in the middle of a great conversation. Come on, you know, just continue that. Finish the thread, finish the dance. You know, maybe if you guys are having drinks, you're giving that look in each other's eyes, and then you're like, let's do one more shot before we go. You know, I'm not advocating you get drunk, you know, blah, 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 but sometimes it can be fun. Having drunk sex with hot girls is pretty great. What did Tucker Max say? If God invented something better than having drunk sex with hot girls, then he's hiding it probably, because it's pretty great. Anyways, back to the example. If you're having drinks with a girl and you just like, you wanna have that moment, like, let's have that shot. And then you have a shot together and you give each other that look of drunken lust, and then you make out, and then, you know, you're holding each other's hands on your way to the Uber, and you get in the Uber and, you know, she's starting to grab your dick and you're starting to, you know, finger her in the back, but you're trying to be quiet because you don't want the Uber driver to hear her macaroni and cheese mix. You're having an exciting time, and it's like you already are having sex, and you know you're gonna have sex, but you're not there yet. It's like your favorite movie came out and you're waiting in line for the tickets, and then you're getting the popcorn and you're like, oh my God, I can't wait. And then you sit down and it begins, and it's like, oh, that's amazing. Same thing with foreplay. You're building it up, and then dick and pussy, and you guys are just fucking going crazy because she's wet as fuck, and also you are hard as fuck. Because a lot of times that I think guys are dealing with ED is because the situation is like thrust upon them. I remember one chick, she knocked on my door and she was, you know, just wearing a hoodie, and then she revealed that she was naked, and she's like, hey, I'm leaving town, I wanna fuck you before I leave. And it was just like such a sudden experience, and I was like, oh my God, here's this smoking hot girl, I was about to go to bed, you know, I was just up playing video games and she wants to have sex, and it was kind of a lot of pressure. And then I ended up having trouble getting it up because it was just, there wasn't the whole seduction there. And I kind of laughed at myself, I was like, oh, that was kind of gay. Yeah, I need her to wine and dine me before she takes me to bed. But the foreplay is going to make the seduction better for you and for her, and it's going to get you in the sex mood. And when you're in the sex mood, you're not going to be worried about work or this thing or that thing. You're going to be completely absorbed in the seduction. And when you're absorbed in the seduction, you're going to be completely focused on your pleasure and her pleasure, and your bodies intertwining, and it's going to make your dick super, super hard. And the last tip is, you want to fuck her really, 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 really hard. Because why is your dick hard if you're not going to fuck her hard? I mean, it's kind of cool when you're just like slowly going in and out and you just have this rock hard dick, and she reaches down and just starts to like slide her hand up and down your dick because it's so hard and she just wants to feel it going in and inside of her. But the best thing to do with this super hard, that was super, I was getting into it. I was like visualizing something that didn't happen that long ago, and I was just like getting into it. And then I realized I'm on camera and I'm on YouTube, and I'm like envisioning myself fucking myself. I don't know, it was like some okay, let me just keep going and hope that you don't pay attention to that. Anyways, you need to fuck her hard because you got a hard dick. And the entire idea of your dick, primally and biologically, is to shove it as far as possible. And that's why it's hard, because it's trying to get as big as possible and fucking splurge a bunch of fucking soldiers onto her cervix so that they can conquer her womb. That's what you're trying to do. You're trying to explode inside of her. And she wants to feel your dick just fucking slamming against her cervix, and then hopefully just like bust into her stomach and just like explode in her stomach and give her an alien that's gonna pop out of it later. Like, you're just trying to just shove it as far as possible. Look at how dirty talk works. Yeah, you like when I split that pussy open, I shove my dick. Like, it's very rough language, right? And girls love rough sex. There is a time for softer, passionate sex. But most of the time, when you're really getting into it and your dick's hard and she's wet, you just wanna fuck her really hard. And I've heard girls say, oh, I don't like rough sex. And then I'm like, I personally know that's fucking bullshit. Or that guy over there who's fucked you told me it was bullshit. So girls like rough sex, you like rough sex, and it's going to engage your masculinity because that's your role in the sexual dynamic, excluding some obvious derivations if you're into other stuff, and that's cool. But for the most part, girls just want to be manhandled, they want their hair pulled, and they want you to just fucking use their body to your heart's content, because that's just the way the sexual energies go. So fuck her really hard, and as you're fucking her really hard, you're gonna see her get more and more submissive and more feminine. You're gonna see her sticking out her tongue, just fucking being a slut for the sake of being a slut and enjoying the shit out of her sexuality. And then you're just gonna see that, and you're gonna turn into this beast, and you're gonna start growling. If you need help with sex, I got some videos here and also in the description. And you're just gonna have a fucking amazing time, and you're gonna look down and you're gonna realize that your dick is super fucking hard, and you fucked her so hard that she's actually bleeding a little bit. So, hope you enjoyed the video. This is Hector Castillo from GirlsChase.com. Remember, girls love rough sex. Be healthy. Stop watching porn. Stop jerking off. Sexualize women. It's okay to want to fuck women. Don't let anyone ever shame you. If you do have any sexual traumas or inhibitions when it comes to sex, either meditate or go see someone and talk about them. And then once you let go of those barriers, and mental and physical, they're going to let you go, and they're going to let you free, and they're going to let your dick go free and be as hard as it wants to be, like Free Willy. Hey, okay. Again, Hector Castillo Poppy from GirlShades.com. Like, subscribe, ring the bell. Check out King of College, my amazing book, in the description below. Check out One Date, another amazing product, in the description below. And bye.